Hey guys, what's going on? It's Steve Cronin. Today we're going to talk about states of consciousness and how they fit within the context of biohacking. That's coming up. Alright guys, so states of consciousness, what are they? This is actually kind of a weird video for probably you guys to watch and for me to make at this moment, because so far this channel, even though it is about biohacking and quantified self, I've pretty much just been like spewing out reviews of smart drugs for like a long time. And that's just because I've like taken so many, I've had so many, over the years, and I really just had a lot of stuff I wanted to get out there. But I don't want this to necessarily be a smart drug review channel for all of time. Smart drugs are an integral part of biohacking. However, that's just one facet of the entire term that is biohacking, which is kind of vague. I actually recorded a video recently, what is biohacking, to try to hone that in a little bit in terms of the future for this channel. So yeah, as I said, I don't want to necessarily just come out with a new smart drug review video every other day. That's not really what biohacking is to me. That's not what quantified self is. We haven't even really been measuring this stuff yet. So this video is kind of an effort to move us forward, even though there will be smart drug reviews coming out regularly, at least for the next month or so, maybe even 2 months, as far as I can envision at the moment. Okay, so states of consciousness. Let's start with, let's define what consciousness is, all right, guys? I've actually really never found a definition of consciousness that I am in love with. I think that it means different things to a lot of people, and different people are going to give you different answers depending on how they're credentialed. So a psychologist is going to give you a different answer than perhaps, a physicist, right? Or perhaps a pastor of some sort is going to give you a different answer than a child. So I kind of like to define consciousness very simply, but vaguely, in terms of having consciousness be synonymous with awareness, right? And awareness, it just means that you have some sort of a subjective experience of what's going on or the world around you. Maybe your interpretation is flawed, maybe you don't really know what's going on in an intricate level, or maybe you can't explain things the way that other people can, but if you have a subjective experience that is an awareness of something like the world or yourself, or things around you, then generally that's what I kind of define consciousness as. Now, as I said, there are people who disagree with me on this, and a lot of that, in my opinion, has to do with how they're credentialed. Myself, I'm biased because I do come from the psychology world, specifically the transpersonal and developmental psych world, so for me, it's kind of easy to just say, okay, we're going to define consciousness as awareness, and go ahead and get that out of the way. But also, I do think it's a really simple definition that's easy for people to understand who don't really want to get all technical and sciencey. So I'm very happy with that. Okay, so a state, right? Because we're going to talk about states of consciousness and how they fit in within the context of biohacking. A state is simply something that's transitory, right? It's something that comes, arrives, and then goes, right? A state can also just mean kind of like a way to describe the current moment, right? When we think about the word state as applied to like a republic, for example, like I live within the United States of America, we have 50 states of America, meaning we have 50 different kinds of America, 50 different ways that America expresses itself, right? The United States, right? So the idea is, within a republic at least, that you can move to a different state that is currently expressing a point of view or perspective that is somewhat in line with your own, right? Because the laws of Texas, where I live currently, are very different from the laws of California or New York, for example, right? They're different states. And so when we think about states of consciousness, it's pretty much just a state is how is your consciousness or awareness being represented at any given point in time, right? States come and they go. So there's three main types of states of consciousness. Now, there are way more than three, but it's very easy to kind of categorize them generally into three different types. So we have waking, that's one, the waking state, the dream state, number two, and the deep dreamless state as number three. And we're going to go through those very quickly and then figure out how does biohacking fit in, right? And you might be asking about altered states, right? And we're going to talk about those probably in a future video, but altered states come in generally within the waking state. So we're going to talk about that right now. So the waking state of consciousness is just what you are aware of right now, what the self is aware of right now. And don't get too hung up on how to define the self or what the I is, right? I being just the letter, the pronoun I, representing the subjective experience, because that's actually what transpersonal psychology addresses, and it has a huge, huge effect on biohacking and the quantified self movement. So I'm actually probably gonna make a future video about that anyway, probably within the next week or so, since I think it's so crucial to moving forward with this channel. So the waking state, right? Just some awareness of the environment. It's very easy for us to tell if we're in the waking state or not, right? Like, we have, we can interact with other people. We see, you know, right now I'm in my apartment, so I see books on my bookshelf behind me. I see my camera in front of me, right? Things are semi-permanent, right? Like, this apartment isn't, like, you know, shifting, changing forms of a bunch. You know, things we generally know when we're in the waking state, because it's generally synonymous with what we term as physical reality, which is just the world that we all kind of experience, and we validate that physical reality pretty much through communication, right? Now, we do, like, some measurements as well and some observation through other means, but generally the root of observation is ourselves, right? We do have machines that measure stuff that can be observers, that's fine, but the root of that observation comes from us, right? And so we validate what's around us through communication. And that kind of is what we see as physical reality, and we experience that reality within the waking state. This is where altered states can come in. This is a lot where smart drugs can come in, and where biohacking can come in within this waking state. But for now, because this video is almost 7 minutes long, we're gonna move forward to the dream state. Okay, so the dream state, when you enter into the dream state, most of us don't actually remember any kind of experience of the dream state, right? We leave the waking state, we are unconscious for the most part, right? So, and by unconscious, since we're talking about states of consciousness, right? Most people don't have an awareness of the dream state. Awareness is generally associated with, now here's where we can measure some stuff and have some correlations being brought in. The awaking state is generally correlated with alpha and or maybe beta, well, primarily beta, but beta or alpha with brain waves, right? And so this you can measure through something like an EEG. So when you strap on those electrodes to someone and then view a readout and you see beta waves or alpha waves, you can be generally certain that those are correlated with someone who is within the waking state of consciousness. You can actually really, here's an easy way to verify if someone's in the waking state of consciousness. You can hold a conversation with them, you're probably good to go, right? Okay, so the dream state, that's generally associated with something like theta waves, right? Theta waves, which also have a lot to do correlative-wise with creativity, for example. Theta waves come up a lot within the dream state. And this is not like deep dreamless sleep, but this is, you know, this is the dreaming, the active, emotional, creative mind at work. You start to lose a sense of self in the dream state, and we're gonna talk about the self later in a future video, and you start to lose, in fact, you don't lose somewhat, you lose completely physical reality, right? Because your reality around you is essentially that of your own mind or a projection of your own mind. This is the dream state of consciousness, and you're, like I said, your self degrades. If I'm in my apartment here and I'm having something what's known as a lucid dream, which there is some strong evidence to suggest that beyond people just saying, hey, like, I remember dreaming last night, I was aware while I was dreaming, I was able to hold my awareness from waking, the waking state of consciousness, down into the dream state, that awareness held, we would term that as lucid dreaming, and there's some evidence, measurable evidence for that, kind of, that might be indicative of kind of validating that experience of people communicating about their experiences within the dream state, but also within the brain, right? So if you had a combination of like alpha waves and theta waves, then, and you had those at the same time being measured while someone was dreaming, then that's indicative of an awareness, right? A waking world type awareness with the dreaming type state of type of consciousness that we just have when we're in the dream state no matter what. So that's kind of cool, and a lot of stuff can be said about the dream state in terms of like what it is, but we don't really know. The dream state could also be associated with stuff like exploring who we are, right? Because we suspect that it's somewhat a projection of ourselves, our own mind. And so a lucid dream would be really helpful to kind of interact with it. Biohacking comes in here in a way that's more therapeutic, that's more discovering who we are as human beings. And we kind of use these devices. This is where quantified self creeps in. We can use these devices to, there was a mask, or there was several iterations of this mask that attempted to try to induce someone to lucid dream. Which I do have a method for that works really well for me, and I will do a video on that in the future. I just can't really say when because there's so much stuff I want to do. I'm coming out with a video every other day, so I'm trying my best to get this info out there. But there are several iterations of a mask that you could wear that I don't remember, that, you know, these were on Kickstarter. I don't remember how many were actually designed or completed or sent out to people. But I'm not sure if it actually read brain waves or determined you were asleep by some other mechanism. However, it would essentially try to give you a subtle signal, you, meaning your awareness, a subtle signal that you were within the dream state. Right, so if it was an EEG, maybe it was looking for predominantly theta waves within a particular type of region of your brain, and then giving you a subtle signal so you could, your consciousness could be shaken a little bit, so you could be aware and get that alpha or beta going while you were dreaming, so you could have a lucid dream, and you could then just discover things about yourself that perhaps are just generally left within the shadow, right? The shadow being a term coined by Carl Jung, right? The shadow just meaning pieces of ourselves that we are not aware of is generally, I think, a good definition of that. And then, of course, the third state of consciousness, and I know I'm speeding through this here, is the deep dreamless state. How does this, you know, reflect with biohacking, and what is it? So it's kind of like a formless state of consciousness where, you know, in the waking state, we have physical reality around us. In the dream state, we have a reality basically of our own projections or our own mind around us that is very, very much changing and evolving and something we don't really have a great awareness of, or at least most of us don't. And then the deep dreamless state is where there's essentially you're aware, but nothing is around you. So you don't, like in a dream state, you don't really have a body, or at least if you do, it's constructed of your own volition. But within the deep dreamless state, you're aware of this kind of like nothingness, formless type of arena. I'm actually not even convinced that I've experienced this. You know, I've been lucid dreaming since I was a small child. I can only really recall one time when I was in Louisiana, in Baton Rouge, where I thought I was having some kind of experience like this. And it came after, you know, waking state I was experienced, and I had this lucid dream, and I went down towards this really very kind of weird void type experience, back up to the dream, back up to the waking state. How does that deep dreamless state, you know, it's associated with the causal realm of reality, what does that have to do with biohacking and the quantified self? Well, we don't really know, and I think there's some cool theories out there. I think perhaps if you read about Stephen Kotler, and he wrote like The Rise of Superman, for example, a book called West of Jesus, which kind of documented how surfing and flow states, which I need to do a video on flow states, perhaps had something to do with curing his Lyme disease, something, as you guys know, I have also had and experienced. So, you know, that would be a causal kind of biohack, as it were. Something that he deemed as flow, maybe incorrectly, but we'll get more into that later. So I think that's a pretty good review or overview of the three major states of consciousness and why they're important to biohacking. So with that being said, as I record future videos, I actually have them pop up in the suggestions to watch. So if I have, by the time you're watching this, if I've already recorded a video about transpersonal psychology, for example, or maybe altered states, what are they? Then I'll have that pop up so you can just go ahead and navigate there, and we'll have some kind of continuity within this whole process. So that's it for now, guys. Take care. Subscribe to my channel if you're interested in biohacking, quantified self, philosophy. This would be a philosophy video, guys. And I hope to see you guys soon. Bye.